Hello everyone, in this video we will see how to analyze the cable when the supports are at different levels, they are not placed at same level. So we will see numerical. A cable ABCD is loaded as shown in figure, and for this four system we have to find the load W and reactions at point A and D. Okay, so if you observe the figure, the horizontal distances between AB, BC and CD are given. Similarly, the vertical distance between AB, BC and CD and the distance between D and A is also given. At point B, there is horizontal force which is of magnitude 260 kN. Okay? And at point C, there is unknown weight W. So, we will solve this problem by drawing free body diagram. So, we will draw free body diagram. Let us show all the points. Forces acting at point B and C. Show all the distances between different points in horizontal direction as well as in vertical direction. Okay. So, now we have to show the reaction component at point A and D. Now, look. We have seen in the cable part there is always tensile type of forces. So from point A towards point B there will be tensile force, and the same force will act in the form of reaction at point A. If you drag this line, it will go to second quadrant, and in second quadrant horizontal reaction component acts along left side and vertical component act along vertical side in upward direction. Similarly at point D, so if you extend this CD line, the reaction component at point D will act in first quadrant, and in first quadrant the horizontal reaction component acts along right side while the vertical component acts along vertically upward side. Okay, now we will see how to solve this numerical by using conditions of equilibrium. So our first condition of equilibrium is summation fx equals to 0. For using condition summation fx equals to 0, I will consider total cable ABCD and I will follow sign conventions as rightward forces positive and leftward forces negative. Now observe free body diagram. In free body diagram, there are three horizontal forces, summation ax going towards left side, 260 kN force going towards right side, and dx force going towards right side. So according to my sign convention, the equation will become minus ax plus 260 plus dx must be equals to 0. Same I have written over here. So I can write ax equals to dx plus 260. So let us say this equation as equation number 1. Now I will apply second equilibrium condition, which is summation fy equals to 0. So for this summation fy equals to 0, I will use sign convention as upward forces positive and downward forces negative. Now again observe free body diagram. Now look, in free body diagram, vertical forces are ay, force w and force dy. So according to my sign convention, equation will form as plus ay minus w plus dy must be equals to 0. Same I have written over here. So my equation will become ay plus dy equals to w. So let us say this equation as equation number 2. Now I will move towards third equilibrium condition, summation m must be equals to 0. You can take moment about any point at point A or at point D. Now here I have taken moment about point A and it must be equals to 0. Now look, sign conventions to be followed. So I am going to use sign convention as clockwise moment negative, anti-clockwise moment positive. Again I am highlighting, you can use any sign convention, you will get same answer. So it sign conventions doesn't matter. Okay. Now take moment of all forces about point A and equate all those moment equals to 0. Now look, AX, AY, these two forces are going to pass through point A, so its moment about point A will be zero. Now you have to consider 260 kN force, how it is going to rotate about point A. It will rotate in anti-clockwise direction, so it will produce anti-clockwise moment about point A. Since force is horizontal, consider vertical distance between point A and B, which is 4.2 meter. Now next force is W. It will rotate in clockwise direction about point A, and its distance, since force is vertical, you have to consider distance horizontal between point A and C, which will be 10 plus 10 equals to 20 meter. Now consider dx force. Now look, this is going to rotate in anti-clockwise direction about point A. Now the distance between point A and D we have to consider. Now which distance you will consider? Force is horizontal, so distance must be vertical. So this distance is 12.8 meter between point A and D. Now take moment of dy force about point A. It will rotate again in anti-clockwise direction. So force is vertical, consider horizontal distance between point A and D, which will be 10 plus 10 plus 10 equals to 30 meter, and equate moment of these four forces equals to zero. Same I have done over here, 260 into 4.2 minus W into 20 plus dx into 12.8 plus dy into 30 equals to zero. So by solving this equation, we will get one equation in terms of dx, dy and w. Let us say this equation as equation number 3. Now we will consider CD part of cable. Now look, we will draw separate freeboard diagram for part CD of cable. Now this is dx, dy force, and at point C there is w force. Now note down the distance CD in horizontal as well as in vertical direction, and let us take moment about point C. Now look, this dy force is vertical, so we will consider horizontal distance. Since dx is horizontal, we will consider vertical distance. Now observe the direction of rotation. Now look, dx force is going to rotate in clockwise direction, so it will produce clockwise moment, negative in nature according to my sign convention, and dy will produce anti-clockwise moment about point C, which will be plus according to my sign convention. Now equation will become minus dx into 4.2 plus dy into 10 must be equals to 0. So we get 4.2 dx equals to 10 dy, so get value of dx in terms of dy. So dx equals to 2.38 dy. Let us say this equation as equation number 4. Now consider BCD part of cable. Draw separate free body diagram for BCD portion of cable. So this is BCD. At point B there is force of 260 kN. At point C there is force W, at D dy and dx. The horizontal distance between B and C is 10 meter, between C and D it is 10 meter. And the vertical distance between B and C is 12.8 meter, while between D and C it is 4.2 meter and between B and D it is 12.8 meter. Now look, I will take moment of all forces about B. Summation MB equals to 0. So moment of this force about this point will become 0. W will rotate in clockwise direction about point B. So it will produce negative moment. Now force is vertical, so distance must be horizontal. So the distance between B and C is 10 meters. Now consider this dx force. How it will rotate about point B? It will rotate in anti-clockwise direction, and since force is horizontal, we have to consider vertical distance between B and D. Now the distance between B and D is, look, it is 12.8 meters. Now consider this dy. Now, how it will rotate about point B? It will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So, since force is vertical, you have to consider horizontal distance. So, it will be 10 plus 10, 20 meter. Now, here, to take moment of force dx, I will require the distance between point B and D. Now, how to get this distance? So, this total distance is 12.8 minus this 4.2. So, you will get total distance as 8.6 meters. So, I have calculated this distance. By mistake, I have shown this distance. Actually, the distance between A and D is 12.8 meters. Okay. Now, take moment about point B. So, it will be minus W into 10 plus DX into B dash D dash plus DY into 20 must be equals to 0. So, 10W plus DX into 8.6 plus 20DY equals to 0. So, use equation 4 and substitute value of DX. According to equation 4, DX is equals to 2.38DY and we have to substitute this value in the above equation. Now look, by substituting value of dx as 2.38W. Now look, minus 10W plus dx is 2.38DY. This will be 8.6 plus 20DY equals to 0. So we are having 2DY terms, make addition of these two equals to 10W. So here you will get value of dy as 0.247W. Now again use equation number 4. So what is equation number 4? Dx is 2.38 dy. So now we are having dy. So 2.38 into 0.247W. So here you will get dx as 0.588W. Now we got values of dx and dy in terms of W. So give numbers to this equation as 5 and 6. Now we will use equation number 3, and in that equation we will substitute value of dy and dx in terms of W. So our equation number 3 is written over here. So in this equation I will substitute dx as 0.588W, dy as 0.247W, and there is one more term of W. So take all W terms on one side. So your equation will reduce to 1092 equals to 5.064W. So here you will get W as 215.64 kilonewton. Now in equation 5 and 6 we are having values of dy and dx in terms of W. Now we got value of W, so substitute that value of W in this equation 5 and 6, and by solving it you will get values of dy and dx. Now use equation 1. Equation 1 is ax equals to dx plus 260. So substitute value of dx, you will get value of ax. Use equation number 2, which is ay plus dy equals to w. Now in this equation we are having value of dy, we are having value of w. So here you will get value of ay. Now, reactions at support and its inclination with respect to horizontal. So, already we have seen in previous videos, reaction is square root of component at that two points, square of it. So, Ra will be ax square plus ay square. Substitute those values, you will get reaction at point A. So, your theta 1 will be tan inverse of ay by ax. So, theta 1 comes 22.77 degree. RD will be dx square plus dy square. So one substitute those values of dx and dy, you will get value of RD. So this is RD. Now we have to find inclination of RD with respect to horizontal. So it will be tan inverse of dy by dx. So your theta 3 comes 22.78 degree. So with this, I hope you have understood this solution for cable having supports at different levels. Thank you.